All right, welcome back, everybody. You know, over the past 10 days, I and 42 other Youpers had just an incredible adventure across Ireland last week. Yeah. So if it's okay with you and with you guys, I'd like to share some of the adventure that we had, okay?
Okay,
sounds good.
All right, so here we go. After we arrived in Dublin, we set out for our first destination, Cobbra Castle, just beautiful. Building date back to the 16th century, but we had all the amenities of modern day. Now, while there, I had my very first Irish coffee. with a lot of the others on the trip and took a chance to walk around, check in some of the scenery. There was a wedding taking place with a traditional bagpiper that announced the arrival of the bride and groom. Nice. And it was just an incredible thing to see. Now, day two on our way to Limerick, we took in the countryside, learned about the people of Ireland and of their past. Along the road, you'll see that yellow stuff. It's called gorse. It's a beautiful yet effective way to keep cattle in, people out. It's got big spikes on it. Oh. The Kilbeggan Whiskey distillery, run to this day by a water wheel. And then when we got back to Limerick, it was a night of fun. We explored the culture of Bunratty Castle and got to take in a medieval dinner where some two Youpers were crowned Lord and Lady of the evening. It was fun. All right, then while we were still in the Limerick area, we visited a working dairy farm. We got the chance to meet Patty and Margaret there and to see how things have changed over several generations. They gave us tea and Guinness cake. Yes, I got the recipe on that, along with stories and more of it was just a really great way to mingle with them and see what they were doing and what their lives were like. Okay, we also went to the Cliffs of Moher. It rained. It was foggy, yeah, but it was just breathtaking. I cannot describe what it was like standing on those cliffs. It was like pictured rocks magnified by 100.
Oh, wow.
Now, also on the day we went to the cliffs, we went to this place. It's called the Burren. It's just this huge expanse of rocks. They've got wildflowers, snails, slugs, and a variety of fossils that they had down there at the Burren. I could have spent a half a day there.
Okay.
But we had to head off to Killarney. We had a great lunch at the Gap of Dunloe, and then after we got into our next stop, Killarney itself, we got a jaunty car ride through the Killarney National Park. The final destination there was a place called Muckross House. Look at that. It's just gorgeous. We were not allowed to take pictures inside Muckross House. It's very grand. They've got stuff online that you can check out. I walked away with a souvenir book. It was astounding in there.
Okay.
Cool. Okay, so now we stay in the Killarney region. We took in the Ring of Kerry the next day. It was very rainy, so you can see a lot of rainy shots. Found the statue of Charlie Chaplin, Puck the Coat. Also a stop at Ladies View, which is attached to the National Park in Killarney. And lots of sheep. We got to also see the Torque Waterfall. That's not normally on the tour, but we were ahead of time. Not Torque Waterfall, Sean, the Torque Waterfall.
Okay.
Of course, he starts twerking right away. Then we head off to Waterford. On the way, we start out at Blarney Castle. That's right. Blarney House and a chance to kiss the stone. That's the view that I zoomed in of where you're standing.
So that's
to
built
kiss the
right
stone.
On the
It's built right on
rocks.
The turret.
Wow.
Yep. Then we got to Waterford, touring the Waterford Crystal Factory. We really got a new appreciation for the hand craftsmanship they do on that. And you know, you see it looks so delicate. Each piece is very heavy. So if you pick up a goblet, you know that's it's got some it's going to have some endurance.
Okay.
And then we went to Dublin, finishing off the trip there. We took time to see the Book of Kells, the old library. Of course, we went to St. Patrick's Cathedral, where inside it was just wonder upon wonder. Also, we stopped by to see the famous bog bodies. We toured through the National Science Museum, the Natural Science Museum, where we got to see that. The locals call it the Dead Zoo.
So
that was an Irish elk.
Okay. Huh. Yep. I know that the prehistoric moose were huge, enormous.
They were enormous, and that was just an elk.
Okay.
So I can't believe it. Our final night, it was an evening of traditional song and dance. We just had a great time all the way around. You know, our plane ride wasn't easy going either way, but it was well worth it. We had just an incredible time. Everybody keeps saying, when's the next one? I don't know. I'm still recuperating from this one, but I'm ready to go. Next time I'll learn, don't pack so many clothes.
I think I'll be going to like Australia or something.
Oh, right. Okay.
I've decided that for
good decision made. Well done.
Yeah. You know, a lot of people wonder, I'll tell you what, taking a coach And a guided tour like that for me was the best. I didn't have to worry about anything. You didn't worry about where you're going to eat. You didn't worry about driving because the roads were like, ah! And it was the route to go. We had a blast.
Very cool.
All right. Now, coming up on our Facebook page, I showed you the Torque waterfalls. This morning on Facebook, we're talking about waterfalls and where some of your favorite UP sites are to see. Sounds like today, Sean, we're going to be picking up some extra water to help them out.
A hefty amount of rain for some, and that's going to create some problems. We'll touch on that. We'll talk about what we can expect for today and through the rest of the week after this.